into a heartfelt prayer tonight. The Bible says, call on me and I will answer. I will show you great and mighty things which thou knowest not. The Lord is nigh them that call upon him. Someone is lifting up his or her voice in worship.
Let the fire from your altar touch my heart. Let the fire from your altar touch my heart. Let the fire from your altar touch my heart.
Sometimes you have no words to say, so say,
yeah, 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 yeah.
It's a chant in the spirit. Hallelujah. It is unto you that we have come. It is unto you our hearts are opened, our spirits are receptive, that you will breathe upon us yet again. For the Bible says, they go from strength to strength, as many as appear before the Lord. 1 Thessalonians 5:17, it says, pray without ceasing. 1 Thessalonians 5:17, pray without ceasing. Someone say prayer. Shout it again, say prayer. Prayer is very, very powerful. When you do not know what to do, pray. It is in the place of prayer that direction comes. When you do not know what to do, pray. Pray even in the spirit, pray in your understanding. I don't know where the solution to these bills will come from. There's already a death sentence around my life and my children health-wise. You do not know what to do, pray. The Bible says the biblical recommendation for managing affliction is to pray. Man of God, pray. Businessman, pray. It does not take a certificate to pray. It takes hunger and passion and the recognition that there is a God that rules over the affairs of men. Say pray.
What commit to prayer. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and what a priest. privilege to carry everything.
In the name of Jesus, every discouragement, every mountain that stands before me, I announce to you that I am the righteous and therefore I am coming out of it. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Following online, pray. Azaria family, make sure you are praying. In the name of Jesus, someone is speaking. As a man of God, a businessman, career person, politician, parent, whatever the situation is, it says, let the weak say, so the weak can say. The weak may not be able to do, the weak may not be able to rise, but the weak can say. And the moment you can say, all other things will begin to fall in line. Someone open your mouth and pray. Speak over your health. Speak over the failing business. Speak over the marital issue. Speak over the ministry issue. Speak over the job challenge. Many are the afflictions of the righteous. Many are the afflictions of the righteous. Someone is praying. Many are the afflictions. Someone pray in the hospital. You are in the hospital, but make sure you are praying. You've lost a loved one, but make sure you are praying. You may be crying listening to me, but make sure you are praying. You may be discouraged, offended with God, but make sure you are praying. Many are the afflictions of the righteous. Nigeria, Africa, I know things may not be as we want for now because of all the economic issues there, but many are the afflictions of the righteous. I dare to say Nigeria is a righteous nation. Therefore, the Lord will deliver him from them all. Pray. I don't know who I'm prophesying to, but in the name of Jesus Christ, I call upon the God of Jeshurun, the one who is able to turn night to day. Let every captivity in your life give way in the name of Jesus Christ. Let every captivity in your life give way in the name of Jesus.
I'm a winner man, is won my battle for me. I'm a winner man, is won my battle for me. I'm a winner man, is won my battle for me.
May you never lack helpers. I'm prophesying to you that in the name of Jesus Christ, may you never lack helpers. That at every point in your life, may there be someone who can arise genuinely and sincerely. I've taught you in discussing destiny helpers. Let me do a 1 minute recap. I have taught you that there are four kinds of destiny helpers. Let me run through them very quickly. Number one, they first are called divine connectors. They do not have the solution to your challenges, but they know who has that solution. And they always are bridges. For instance, the slave girl connecting Naaman to Elisha. Divine connectors do not have the power to solve your problem, but they know somebody who knows somebody who can connect you. And statistic tells us that everybody is maximum of four people away from where your solutions are. No matter how serious that problem is, four people strategically arranged will connect you and your solution. Number two, men of influence. The second category of destiny helpers, men of influence. These are men who have the credibility, they have the track record, they have the ears of the territory. Their endorsement about you and their speaking over you can rewrite age-long narratives in a moment. One person can sign a signature and say, truly, this man is supposed to go to prison, but at my influence, I write something and that's it. Can I tell you, God still works with men, oh, and there are men who are gatekeepers, whether they are believers or not. I've told you that there are gatekeepers you don't cast away. God grants you favor to be able to pass through them. Some of you have been grounded at this point. Afflictions have remained indefinite in your life because you do not understand the power of destiny relationships, the power of destiny helpers, men of influence. One person, his signature can give you a job, his signature can veto whatever limitation and grant you access. Everything you see on earth is controlled by men. Behind every system is a man, and that man has a will, he has an emotion, even if he's the unrighteous judge that was in Luke 18. A man who does not fear God nor regard men, that's a dangerous man. May you never meet such a man in your life. I say, may you never meet such a man in your life. A man that does not fear God and does not regard men. You can't talk to him about God, you can't bribe, you can't do anything, you're in trouble. Does not fear God, does not regard men. But the Bible says a weak woman came and used a strategy to weary that man away until he avenged her adversaries. There is always a man behind every system on earth. And let me tell you, when God wants to help you, he gives you access to great men. Don't insult great men. Don't insult rich men. Don't insult people who have paid the price to rise to certain positions. Rather, obtain wisdom by God and say that God should strategically position you. Joseph, you need Pharaoh to manifest your destiny. Daniel, you need Darius, you need Nebuchadnezzar to manifest your destiny. And these are systems and people who God himself recognizes. Are we together now? Number three, you need gifted men. I'm just doing a quick recap on destiny helpers to buttress point four. You need gifted men, especially for many of us here who are businessmen or even men in ministry. One gifted person can save you financial leakages. One gifted person can bring efficiency to your life beyond your imagination. The best corporations in the world sometimes are behind them are a few intelligent people who are making global impact, redefining civilization. The whole corporation is sharing the glory, but the truth is that the brains behind them may not be more than four or five. Gifted men. Finally, and maybe not most importantly, but more importantly, burden bearers. I told you that the assignment, burden bearers are not after your titles, they are not after whoever or whatever you are, they are after you as a person. Burden bearers may not be able to move you forward, but they have an assignment to stop you from going back. These are men who will cry with you. These are people who will see your nakedness and still cover you and cry with you. May God send burden bearers to your life. In the name of Jesus, the Son of the Living God.
I will hold on through the storm. I will hold on to your word. My life will soon reveal you're the lifter of men. The lifter of men.
No matter what I'm going through,
I will hold on through the storm. I will hold on to your word. My life will soon reveal you're the lifter of men.
One more time.
I will hold on through the storm. I will hold on to your word. My life will soon reveal your lifter of men.
Man of God, you will rise again. Because you are the righteous. Businessman, you will rise again. Because you are the righteous. I speak to every family here. North, east, south, and west. You will rise again. That statement, Ichabod, that has been used over your life, the departure of the glory, that men look at your life and it looks like it's a warning and a lesson to others. This God that you call Olowo Gogoro, the one that can turn the life of men around. When God arises from his throne, he says, let God arise, let God arise, let God arise, and all his enemies be scattered. Let God arise and and financial affliction scattered. Let God arise and every curse and every yoke be scattered. That the Lord shall deliver him from them all, financial afflictions, marital afflictions, ministerial afflictions. My Bible says many, not few, many are the afflictions of the righteous. Hallelujah. I'm praying it again. I don't know who has been ordained by God to be stationed around your life and your destiny, but in the name of Jesus Christ, I call on my God, who is also your God, from now to the end of June, may the Father of Spirits summon every destiny helper in the name of Jesus Christ. I don't know who has concluded about you. I don't know what devil. I know you may not carry a semblance of the palace, but when you are chosen, you are chosen. It's as simple as that. Hala shaleka paratosia, krakata balaka toshka frantege baletia. The lifter of men, the lifter of men, the one who can wipe away the tears of men. Hali shateka parusiata. Listen, are you ready to receive? In the name of Jesus, the Son of the living God, the one who has raised men and the one who has anointed men, I speak over your life and I speak over your destiny. Every affliction that has brought you tears, that has brought you shame, that has brought you pain, in the name of Jesus, the Son of the living God, I decree and declare that affliction comes to an end now. 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 It said, they are taken for a prey, and none saith restore. I've come as a voice of restoration, and in the name of Jesus, I prophesy to someone, between now and the end of June, I stand by the God who has raised men, the one who has given the grace to appoint unto men. In the name of Jesus, between now and the end of June, return with strange testimonies. Return with strange testimonies. I program strange testimonies around your life in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak to everyone in ministry here. I don't know what has brought you down. I don't know what is the area of struggle, but I prophesy to you, rise to the place of prophecy. Rise to the place of destiny. Rise to the place of prophecy. Rise to the place of destiny. In the name of Jesus Christ. You may be here and your affliction has to do with losses and pains. You lost money, you lost things, you lost relationships, you lost opportunities. In the name of Jesus, like Samuel prophesied to Saul, I decree and declare, may that missing donkey, whatever it is, I command it to return back to your life. I command it to return back to your life in the name of Jesus Christ.
I have seen, no ear has heard what God has prepared for me.
I want you to open your mouth and pray. I'm releasing my faith with you and I'm about to speak over your life. You will marvel and wonder at the power of this God after tonight's service. Go ahead and pray. He has given us the grace and the unction to speak, been commanded to bless, and this we must do. But I'd like you to release your faith. Don't spare, don't be quiet. Don't let the devil lie to you that God cannot bring you deliverance. Someone is praying. Is it your marriage? Is it finances? Is it your health? Is it your ministry? Is it a new level in your life? Is it your work with God, your prayer life, your word study life? Is it your family? Go ahead and pray. It says to be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving. It says, let your request be made known unto God. Let me speak over you that every unclean spirit, like the Bible calls it, a spirit that is not of the Christ, that has attached itself to any situation around your life, manipulating it and creating pain, I separate you from that spirit now. I separate you from that spirit now. I separate you from that spirit now. And I decree and declare, let the blessing speak on your life. Let the blessing speak on your finances. Let the blessing speak over your family. Let the blessing speak over your ministry. Let the blessing speak. Go and prosper in the name of Jesus. Rise and scale heights in destiny in the name of Jesus. I speak life to your prayer life, life to your word study life, in the name of Jesus Christ. No one under the sound of my voice will die prematurely. I say it again, no one under the sound of my voice will die prematurely. In the name of Jesus Christ. And for one last time, let me speak favor over you. For God's sake, let your heart be open to receive. In the name of Jesus, I prophesy this grace that is called favor. Let it rest on your life. Let it produce extraordinary results. Men rise into your help. Men rise into your rescue. God using men to roll away shame, to roll away reproach. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. So shall it be. So shall it be. So shall it be. Who shall ascend to the hill of the Lord? And who shall stand in his holy place? Who has not lifted up his soul unto vanity, the Bible says, nor sworn deceitfully, that he shall receive a blessing from the Lord. And then, here is the ultimate test. Whoever is Lord in this earth must be able to go out of this earth and come back at will. That was the one test no other deity passed. Because you see, according to the law of territory, once you come out of this domain, someone inside must be the one to call you back. You can't bring yourself inside. So all other gods exited this earth, but those gates did not open for them to come back. And here is this one who came out by himself. And when he was about to return, the gate said, there was a proclamation, lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be lifted, O ye ancient doors. Listen carefully. Why? It says that the King of glory may come in. Hold on. And the gates, ask a question. Many have come trying to enter back, but who is this King of glory? And it says the Lord, strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. And the gates opened, and he stepped into this realm and said, all hail, all power, authority, exousia has been given to me in heaven and in earth. Go with that backing, go with that consciousness that your defender is the Lord. My deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by, my deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by, your deliverer is coming, your deliverer is standing by. Listen to me. There are two people who will shout under the anointing now. Please bring them out. Please make sure that they are defended. I just saw this in the spirit. We are praying now. I just saw a strong anointing. Just two people. One loud shout to the hearing of everybody. Please bring them out. Shabala Subratikidya. Please bring them. So the Bible says, the woman wearing blue, my dear, lift your hands. I'm seeing oil coming on your head right now. Bring her out. You are the covenant keeping God.
Oh, covenant keeping God.
Oh Lord, you
Yahweh,
the covenant keeping God.
Yahweh, the covenant keeping God.
Hallelujah. 3 months from now, go and write it. Your life will change in a way that you will never forget. I speak to you by the Spirit of God. I stretch my hands towards you. Listen to me, my friend, look at me. Remember, once upon a time in the land of Samaria, a prophet came and said, by this time tomorrow. And a foolish man said, even if God will open the heavens, and he said, you will see it, just to witness that God does not lie, but you will not partake of it. Remember, the Bible says there remaineth a rest for the people of God. It says, today if you hear his voice, do not harden your heart like they did in the provocation in the wilderness. They limited God by saying, can God make a way? Can God make a way? This lady, my dear, in the name of Jesus, the yoke of witchcraft, I curse it now from your life and from your family. For it is written, blotting out every handwriting and every ordinance that spoke against us, the Bible declares that he nailed it to his cross. He nailed it to his cross. The victory of Jesus is complete. The victory of Jesus is a fact. But it remains theory until there is faith and understanding that translates that reality here and now. My friend, you go back rejoicing in the name of Jesus, the Christ of God. Hallelujah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years you've been trusting God for the fruit of the womb. 5 years. Who is that? Please don't be embarrassed. I will pray generally now. Make sure it is 5 years exactly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The Lord is showing me this. Who is that? I want to pray for you. Mama, are you standing for yourself? I'm seeing your daughter. What's her name? I want to pray for you. Hold on, madam. Don't worry. I will pray for you. Is your daughter here?
England. Huh? She's hold in on. England.
She's in England. She's a medical doctor.
Medical doctor.
12, 13, 14, 15, 16 years. How many years?
16 years.
16 years barren. I want to pray for you. Madam, please give this woman the mic. Are you the one trusting God for the fruit of the womb?
18 years, yes sir.
1, 3.
18.
Or 18.
1, 8.
You,
yes,
18.
Yes.
Do you believe in Jesus?
Yes.
You see, let me tell you this. Before you believe a man, don't just find out about God. Find out about the man too. You know, the Bible says it is sin to minister above your level of grace. It says to minister according to the level of grace. This is the Jesus that we present to the nations. The one who can heal. The one who can bless. My dear, don't be embarrassed, but I want... What's your name?
Florence.
Florence.
Yes, sir.
Don't be embarrassed. I want to pray for you. I'm seeing a lot of miscarriages.
9 miscarriages, sir.
How many?
9.
Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray over these people standing. Help her. The power of God is coming on her.
Ah.
There is nothing you cannot do.
If you have said it,
in the name of Jesus Christ. Please just make contact with your stomach as a prophetic point of contact. In the name of Jesus, who is the Christ of God, I join my faith with the angel over this house, and in Jesus' name I prophesy to you who are standing here, according to the time of life, in the name of Jesus, who is the Son of the living God, return with miracle children. Look what is happening to this woman. Out of her now, in the name of Jesus. Out of her now, in the name of Jesus. I release every chain that holds anyone here, in the name of Jesus. Whether you're standing in for yourself, you're standing in for your children, in Jesus' name, the Christ of God, return with testimonies. But I'm saying the Lord is asking me to rebuke delay. Now listen, please. You know that the spirit of delay is at work in your life when the only thing that goes forward is your age. The only thing, help them please, help that man. The only thing that moves forward is your age. He says the spirit of God is upon me. I want to pray for you. The power of God will come on a few of you. Please, whether you are an usher or not, do well to help them so they don't injure themselves. Right now, I stretch my hands. In the name of Jesus Christ, everyone under the sound of my voice, please return back. Who is a victim of delay? Right now, as I pray, the power of God will come on you. Bring them out. In the name of Jesus, at the count of three. 1, 2. Take that grace. Bring them out. Bring them out. Help them. Please bring them out. Hold that lady. Let her not injure herself. I cause delay. You are a spirit. We stand in the name of Jesus, sitting on the destinies of men. Every spirit. Help this woman. Help this woman behind the man of God, please. Delay. Go. Delay. Go. And the hand of the Lord came upon Elijah, and he ran and overtook the chariots of Ahab down to Jezreel. I cause delay in the name of Jesus. I cause delay from your life, from your habitation. I cause delay.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
There is
power in the name of Jesus. So break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. So break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
Open your mouth in 1 minute and cause every delay. I release myself now in the name of Jesus. Are you praying? You came to church to pray. Lift your voice and pray. Under this corporate anointing, every delay, help them, that would not let me go. In the name of Jesus, I decree and declare liberty by the Spirit. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Now please listen. My goodness. Anyone here experiencing delay? That people are moving forward, but your destiny is staying in one place. Birthday after birthday, I stand in the name of Jesus. By prophecy, I push you to the next level. I push you to the next level. I shake a kaposta, a break it, 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 a break Jesus' name. Entrepreneurs, business people, I want to pray for you. You see, there is a grace for visibility. It is one thing to have products and services that are needed and useful. It is one thing to package those products in a superior way. It's one thing to have the ability to serve it to a targeted consumer base, but you need the grace that makes for visibility. In Acts chapter 12, the Bible says Peter was bound hand and feet, and there were about 8 soldiers locking him in the prison. Listen carefully. Acts chapter 12. Then the Bible says when the angel came, the chains fell off, and it reveals there a mystery. He says that he went through the first gate. He was out of the prison, but he was still not safe. He went to the second gate. Then the Bible makes an instructive statement that he came to the iron gate that opens up to the city. There is a gate that opens up to the city. Listen carefully. When that gate is open, all you see is the city. It's a gate that controls visibility. It is the iron gate. You can have products and services. You are not in prison, but the city does not know you are there. The Bible says he has broken the gates of brass and cut the bars of iron in sunder. Are you ready to receive? In the name of Jesus, who is the Son of the living God. The grace that makes for visibility. You don't have to bring them under the anointing because of space. But I stretch my hands right now in the name of Jesus. I'm seeing the number 3131. In the name of Jesus, everyone here who has what it takes for the world to celebrate you, everyone here, dreams and visions, help them, products and services, you have labored, you've been well mentored, but something is covering your visibility. By this grace, in the name of Jesus, take that anointing. I command the city to hear you. Lagos, hear them. Lagos, hear them. Lagos, hear them. Southwest, hear them. Nigeria, hear them. Please pay attention, we are still praying. Can I pray for restoration? There is a grace that restores. Son of man, he said, can these bones live again? Hear me. Every time there were losses in the Bible of any kind, it was the office of the prophetic to bring restoration. Any kind. Whether it was the axe head or the wives of the sons of the prophets. Alas, master, for it was borrowed. It is the office of the prophetic to speak restoration. He said they are taken for a prey and none sayeth restore. You can lose things, but when you lose time, you really lost. But in the economy of God, he can restore things and he can restore time. Listen to me. There are people, by the normal sequence of life, you should not be at this level. Things happen in your life. Restoration is not progress. Restoration is beyond progress. If you have been impeded by life, once that constraint leaves you and you move forward, that's not restoration. That's progress. Restoration is God picking you and placing you where you would have been if that challenge were not there. Believe this. Please believe. Please believe. Please believe. I want to declare restoration. You will marvel and wonder at what happens to you at this prayer. In the name of Jesus, I call upon the God of my covenant for everyone here who is trusting God for any kind of restoration. Every destiny helper that must be used in this season to bring about a restoration, I provoke their ministry over your life. I provoke their ministry over your life. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. God is a God that heals. I have been a victim of sickness myself. I know what sickness can do. I have seen the healing power of God myself. I know healing is real. There are men and women here following by TV, internet, and here in our local environment. You're trusting God for miracles, healing miracles. Listen to me. Jesus heals. His power heals. Lay your hands where you are trusting God for a miracle. I want to pray for you right now. If it's a part of your body you cannot touch, just make contact with your chest.
Spirit of the Sovereign Lord, oh, come and make your presence known, reveal the glory of the Lord. You're the Spirit of the Sovereign Lord, come and make your presence known, reveal the glory of the Lord. Let the weight of the glory that is all around us, let the light of your river flow, let the truth of your kingdom let it reign in us, let the weight of your glory.
Please hear me. Are we together? Please lay your hands. I want to pray.
I see miracles everywhere. Miracles everywhere. Miracles everywhere. Right now.
Now, I don't know why God does this. It is a sign and a wonder. But there's going to be a loud shout. After that shout, the healing power of God will begin to flow and I will pray. I need to explain this because sometimes you see, the way God works with us is really very mysterious why he does it sometimes. A loud shout, the power of God just comes upon a lady. A loud shout. Sometimes I really don't know why that happens. But I believe that is a sign and a wonder. The Bible says the shouts of joy and victory shall not depart from the tent of the righteous. Praise the name of the Lord. The moment that shout happens, then I'll begin to minister to the sick. But you lay your hands right now. I want to pray for you. This is a supernatural power of God. My God, there's such a strong anointing. Such a strong anointing in this place. You're already receiving, but this instruction God gives me, the power of God will come upon someone, a lady. So now we begin to pray. Please agree with me. In the name of Jesus. 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 Now every devil that is back of any infirmity, in the name of Jesus, I command that your power is broken now. Let God's people go free now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Now I declare, be healed in Jesus' name. Be healed in Jesus' name. My God, just help those under the anointing. Be healed in Jesus' name. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, be healed in Jesus' name. The power of God is going through your body now. Help them, please. Help them. Be healed in Jesus' name. blind eyes be opened now. Partial complete blindness be opened now. There are some people having pain at the backside, your lumbar vertebra, be healed. The power of God is touching you right now. Every kind of bone condition, you're here, you're on crutches, you're on a wheelchair, you don't have to bring them out. You don't have to bring those under the anointing out. There's no space because some other people will come. You're on a wheelchair, you're on crutches. Right now I declare in the name of Jesus, stand up. Stand up and lift your crutch and walk. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. Every blood condition, every genotype issue, we change it now. HIV, be healed now. Cancer, be healed now. The Lord is ministering to me. You don't have to come out. There are a number of ladies with multiple lumps around your breast area. The power of God is touching you right now. After this prayer, you'll check it. You will not find it again. In the name of Jesus. I'm seeing there's a gentleman. You have what looks like a swelling at the back of your neck. After this prayer, you check it right now. You'll find out that it's gone completely. In the name of Jesus. Every blood condition goes right now. Migraine headache, very severe pounding migraine headache, the Lord is healing you right now. I'm seeing someone, you have this recurrent pattern. It's like every month you have to treat typhoid or malaria. Every month, no matter how well you treat it, it still comes back. The power of God is touching you right now. I'm seeing three people, the Lord is healing them from pile. In fact, for one of you, it's a very severe issue. You cannot even go to the toilet because of how inconveniencing it is and because of the excruciating pain. We come in the name of the Lord Jesus. Let there be healing for you. I see some of you lifting photos of your loved ones, lifting the pictures of your loved ones wherever they are. And those of you following by way of TV, following online, in the name of Jesus, we decree and declare the healing power of Jesus leaves this altar right to your homes, to your offices. In the name of Jesus, your homes, your offices, your devices, let there be miracles. In the name of Jesus, the Christ of God. In the name of Jesus Christ. There's someone, your right ear, you feel, you know how this is, like there's water, you are trying to get it to come out. As soon as we are done praying, check yourself, you'll find out that a miracle has happened to you. In the name of Jesus. There is a woman, you're not exactly a young lady, I'm seeing that I don't know, it's not appendicitis, but there is a severe, looks like there's a mast just around your lower abdominal area. In the name of Jesus Christ, as I pray for you, I command that mass to disappear now. The Lord is showing me a family. Your mother, mama, is in the hospital right now as I am speaking. The power of God is touching her where she is. This is a teaching hospital. In the name of Jesus, let there be a miracle. Now, for time's sake, whether I mention your case specifically or not, in the name of Jesus, who is the Christ of God, he's been exalted both as Lord and as Christ, I declare, be healed now. Be healed now. Be healed now. Oh, he's able. Are you celebrating miracles? Oh, oh,
oh, he's able.
My God is able to do
just what
miracles are happening everywhere.
He will do. He's gonna fulfill every promise. Every promise to you.
The name of the Lord. In the name of Jesus, who is the lifter of men, I decree and declare, in no time your world will look at you with shock and wonder. May the lifter of men lift you. May the lifter of men lift you.
You will never be the same. You've touched His grace. Your life is changed. You will never be the same. You will never be the same. You've touched His grace.
Hallelujah. In 1 minute, let your expectations rise to heaven. Please go ahead. Jesus is here. Jesus is Lord. All over the nations, follow with hunger in your heart. Please lift your hands and pray. Everyone, everyone, lift your voice and pray. You are lifter. Shalabakata brandegede balada balada. Shalabarakoto Faces me, O God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Genesis 21 from verse 1 and 2. And the Lord visited Joshua Selman as he has said. And the Lord did unto Joshua Selman as he has spoken. The Bible says Sarah conceived. You don't have to be a woman to conceive. This kind of conception, there are visions, there are things you can carry. Your mind is a womb too. And bear Abraham a son, even in old age, at the set time which the Lord God has spoken. Father, as you have spoken, do to me. As you have spoken, do to me tonight. Shake para tu selegele balakatasya. Shala, shala barakota balababa. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. I'm seeing people laughing in the spirit. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. The power of God is going to come on those people. This is very strange, but I want you to carry them and bring them out like an outburst of holy laughter. There is a prophecy for them. Bring them out. This is a ministry of signs and wonders. There is nothing superstitious here. It is the mighty act of God in the midst of His people. Bring them. The Bible says the shouts of joy and victory shall not depart from the tent of the righteous. Please bring them. An outburst of laughter is not something you can control. God of heaven. These people are not, this is not just some carnal manifestation. God is establishing great victories in their lives. Hallelujah. Victoria. I'm hearing the name Victoria. Who is Victoria? I presume there may be many people with that name, but I want to speak to you now. Hold on, please. Don't rumple yourself. Where are you coming from? Huh? Mama, where are you coming from?
I'm here in Abuja, but I come from Kaduna.
From Kaduna?
Yes.
I want to pray for you. The power of God is coming on one of you here. Help them, please. Please don't come out carelessly. Don't come out carelessly. If you don't have any business coming out, please, there's order in the house of God. Inasmuch as these are manifestations, don't worry. God is going to visit you. We are not wasting our time. I'm hearing a name, Olusegun. Olusegun, this is a Yoruba name. Olusegun, you are wearing a short dress, a short-handed dress. Is there someone like that? Olusegun. Who is that? What's your name?
Olusegun.
From where?
From Kogi State.
I want to pray for you. What do you do, sir?
I manage the town of my friend for us.
I want to pray. You heard what I was teaching about lifting. This is what is going to happen to you. My friend, believe God. Oh, God is a lifter of men. Hallelujah. Mama, please lay your hand on. I hope you are not embarrassed. Can I talk to you? I want to rebuke BP, high blood pressure. High blood pressure. I want to rebuke it in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, something is about to happen here. Now, please look at me. Everybody pay attention. Let me explain before it happens. You see, the apostolic and the prophetic call, if and when administered within the boundary of scripture and with spiritual intelligence, outside of superstition and rubbish and nonsense, when it is administered within the boundary of scripture, can work wonders. And you have to be flexible when you are in an apostolic and a prophetic atmosphere. In as much as scripture remains the basis of all that we do, the dynamics of its operation, the Bible says there are diversities of gifts. Are we together now? There are diversities even of operation. Now, I confess to you, the world is watching, and I want to say something before I pray. There are certain gifts and manifestations that God has put upon my life that I was almost tempted to shelve them for a while until I studied through scripture or in the life of they that have gone ahead of us, so that would not bring error in the body. But I searched, and I did not really find anyone I know operating this dimension of what is about to happen. And because of that, I went to scripture, and then I found out that there were things that were hidden, that were not known in time past, but that in these days God had revealed them, who is apostles and prophets. The Lord would open my eyes and show me the map of a nation or the map of a city, and I would see light would point a particular region, and the moment I announce it, all the people from that region, the power of God begins to touch them. This is a sign and a wonder. When it started in my life, I said, what is the meaning of this? Are we together now? And I'm saying that because this is what I'm seeing. I'm now seeing that vision right now of a map, and the light of God is touching Kogi State. This is what I'm seeing. Listen, help them, please. You see what I'm saying? Kogi State. Kogi State. Bring them out. Kalatuski de brakatushiata, Kebrantos kalibrakatusiata, Kogi State. God is bringing deliverance. There are foundations, there are altars that have tied the destinies of men down. In the name of Jesus, I come by the apostolic and the prophetic. Kogi State, doesn't matter what local government, in the name of Jesus, by the power that raised Christ from the dead, we arrest everything. Please don't come out on your own. Palisa breketushia takara sutiash. Paruzentesh kabarika tuskiata. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. These things are manifestations of the Spirit. It is to profit the believers. Yeah. Hear me. Except God is not God, everything that followed you here this night to tie your destiny, I declare by the power of the Holy Ghost. Help them, please. It must let you go now. It must let you go now. Covenant, it must let you go now. Yokes of ancestry, it must let you go now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Now, there is someone here in politics. The power of God is coming on you. I'm not a politician. I don't play politics. I'm a man of God, but I love politicians. I love great people. I don't run away from them. We are sent to minister to them. But there is a politician right now. I'm talking, the power of God is coming on the person. Just hold the person. I want to prophesy. If that is a woman, just hold her. I want to speak to her, because I'm seeing her climb a ladder. There is a strange political door that is about to open up for her. Listen, this is the house of God. It's impossible to come here and return back. Minister Dunsin already told us here, I am that I am. Just keep her there. You don't have to lift her. Just keep her there. Madam, we respect you. We do not insult your pedigree in any way. It's just to speak over your life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I come, I use her as a point of contact. I don't know why God is speaking to those who are politicians. If you are in politics here and you are being grounded by any reason, I stand in the name of Jesus. You see, every state rises based on the king, priest, prophet formation. The king, priest, prophet formation. I declare in the name of Jesus, everyone here, politically, may my God lift you to the next level. May my God lift you to the next level by the power that raised Jesus from the dead. Ene Ojo. Ene Ojo. Is there a name like that? Ojo. What's your name? Huh? Give, please, is the mic working? What's your name?
Enoja.
From where?
Kogi State.
Kogi State. Stand here. I want to pray for you. You believe in Jesus? Where are you coming from? In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray for you. Every door that has been closed over your family, I'm speaking to you now. In the name of Jesus, who is the Son of the Living God, may that door be opened now. Madam, what do you do? Hold on, please. Is this mic working? Please, media, help us.
I'm a politician.
You're a politician?
Yes, sir.
I hope you're not embarrassed.
No, sir.
Don't cry, madam. God did not bring you here to embarrass you. I'm speaking to you in the open, in the name of Jesus Christ. I don't know whether, in the name of Jesus Christ, rise to a new level in your political career. By the power that raised Christ from the dead. There is a kingmaker anointing. Listen to me. Kingmakers never become kings, but they enthrone kings and they remove kings. It's a grace. In the name of Jesus, may the Lord honor you. All of you who are standing here, my dear, shout Jesus as loud as you can. You. That's the name that is above every other name. I pray for all of you who are here. Everything holding you down right now, I speak in Jesus' name. Let it let you go now. It must let you go by the power that raised Christ from the dead. The Lord wants to set a family free. I'm seeing that the men in that family keep dying. This is what I'm seeing. This is a pattern. All the men, something continues to happen to them. Remember that happened to the widow at Nain? Her husband died, her only son died. Madam, can I pray for you? In the name of Jesus, I stretch my hands. I'm seeing chains around your chest and your hand. In Jesus' name, Help her, please. Look at this. Out of her now. Please come. I hope you're not embarrassed, sir. Where are you coming from, sir? I want to pray for you. I'm seeing you trying to climb a ladder, and the ladder is breaking and bringing you down. And the Lord is saying to prophesy to you so that you will rise. This is what I'm seeing. You believe that? In the name of Jesus, I stretch my hands. I decree and declare the power that lifts by the God of heaven. May that grace come upon you. May that grace come upon you. And you will rise in a way that will surprise you. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Now I want to pray. The Bible says even the lawful captives. Hold on. Do you know what it means to be a lawful captive? To be a lawful captive means there is a legitimate ground upon the which the devil is taking advantage of you. But it says even the lawful captive. At the count of three, I want you to shout the name Jesus inside here, following online, at the overflow. When we shout this name, we let the nations know that he's the doer of these things. Now, the moment we shout that name, listen to me. There are chains and there are yokes that have tied people down. Some of you, as you are standing, you are representing families. At this shout, the fire from heaven will fall upon you. Please, I want you to bring them out. Bring your various overflow. Father, there are men and women who have been under yokes of bondage. All kinds, bondages of delay, bondages of retrogression, the ill speakings of people. And the Bible declares, for this purpose was the Son of God made manifest, that he may destroy the works of the evil one. Therefore, Lord, as we lift up this shout, the healer, the same way the walls of Jericho fell, let everything that does not name the name of Christ give way. Are you ready now? At the count of three. One, two, three. Shout Jesus. I command every power. I command every force. Bring them out. Every yoke of ancestry holding God's people down, in the name of Jesus, the Son of the living God, be broken now. Be broken now. Be broken now. Be broken now. My God. Oh, God had so highly exalted him and giving him a name and office above every other office, above thrones, above dominions. I declare every power holding you down, bring them out. That power is dislodged now. We're still praying. Please bring them out. Halakato sadeketeba shadeketebe rekotos koto brandegedia shagapakatos. Some of you are representing families. God is asking me to pray. The power of God is going to come upon you, but it's not just for yourself, it's for your entire family. Lord, every family represented here, makatos keba, that is under any kind of yoke, I declare by the Spirit of God, in the name of Jesus Christ, that yoke is broken now. Broken now. Broken now. Broken now. Every time good things are about to manifest, you keep walking, but just when it's about to happen, you may go back and have dreams and encounters and wake up and you will have bought precious things. Shabakatakata, embrekete basikata. Anyone here that experiences failure just at the edge of breakthrough, may fire fall upon you now. May fire fall upon you now. May fire fall upon you now, in the name of Jesus Christ.
Who is like him? Lion and the lamb, seated on the throne. Mountains bow down, every ocean roll, to the Lord of Lords. We will praise Adonai from the rising of the sun to praise.
Hallelujah. Elijah. I'm hearing a name, Elijah. Elijah, we are going to pray for the sick shortly. Please stretch your hands towards me. I just saw something in the spirit. If you can, just stretch your hands towards me. I saw a vision, and I'm seeing what looks like a bag being given to people. And the Lord is telling me, this is, I'm seeing written on it, good news. I'm seeing the number 71. Just stretch your hands towards me. Father, hold on please. From my left to my right, everyone who must receive this, inside, outside, right now, I stretch my hands. May that anointing come upon you. Help them please. In the name of Jesus, sounds of good news, sounds of good things, sounds of good, help them. Some of you, news that you have been waiting for many years, by the power of the Holy Ghost, suddenly. What do you do? You are Elijah. What do you do?
Pastor.
You are a pastor. Where? You have your own church? Can I pray for you? You are Elijah. Hold on please, don't. Mr. Man, I'm seeing fire coming on you now. Take that grace in the name of Jesus. You will never be the same again. In the name of Jesus Christ. Pastor, can I pray for you? Listen, we are co-laborers, and God granted us grace to help one another. Are we together now? I stretch my hands towards you by the power that raised Christ from the dead. In the name of Jesus, may the Lord anoint you. May your ministry step into profound dimensions of signs and wonders. In the name of Jesus Christ. My God. Please look up. I'm seeing a very interesting vision. The Lord just opened my eyes, and I saw a grave, and I saw it open, and I saw things, not people, things that are there coming out. I'm declaring to someone, this is not just restoration, this is resurrection. There are some of you, they've concluded things about you, about your family, about businesses. I call upon my God, everything that has been buried over your destiny, that you will not rise. Conclusions made over your family. I call upon my God, who is your God. Talita kumi, that which is dead, come back to life. Talita kumi, that which is dead, come back to life. Help them please. Every family, dying businesses, dying families, come back to life by the power of the Holy Ghost. Zainab, I pray for all of you. In the name of Jesus Christ, may the power that raised Christ from the dead rest upon you. My dear, this lady, shout Jesus as loud as you can. My friend, what do you do?
Sales boy.
You are a sales boy.
Yes.
Where?
Ikuba. I'm selling gas.
You are selling
gas.
Gas.
Refilling of gas.
Will you believe what I will tell you?
Yes, sir.
Go and register a company.
Okay.
Huh? God is taking you into oil and gas. Stand up, my friend. We are not entertainers, so we fear God. Even if it is 3 months, in the name of Jesus, barrenness dies now. Barrenness dies now. Barrenness dies now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Madam, I pray for you according to the time of life. In the name that is above all names, go and tell your husband that the Lord has brought visitation for you. In the name of Jesus Christ, help her please. Praise the Lord. I want to pray for you, Zainab. In the name of Jesus Christ, may the Lord bring a visitation for your family.
Amen.
A supernatural visitation.
Amen.
Everyone trusting God for a job. I just saw something now. Please believe. You are trusting God for a job. Wherever your job is, in the name of Jesus Christ, may God take you there right now. I decree and declare by the power that raised Christ from the dead. Some of you, by this time next week, I stand by the God of my covenant and I declare, by this time next week, may God surprise you. You will come and stand here and you will testify of the marvelous hand of God in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. We are going to pray for the sick shortly. I'm hearing a name, Pius. Who is Pius? Pius. You are Pius. You are a worker here. You are a new security here. It's still the same thing. All this ministry, doesn't whether you are a worker, you know, most times people have a cliche in churches that workers don't receive anything, only other people get. No, this once Jesus shows up, including me who is speaking, everybody, you will swim in that river and you receive. Are we together? I want to pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare by the power of the Holy Spirit. No, the Pius I'm seeing is wearing white like me, like this. This is what you are wearing. You are surprised. This is the place of encounter. This is the place of surrender. Sir, don't worry, I'll still pray for you. We love our workers. You are a faithful. How could I'm just trying to say that this is was not the word, you understand? But it means that, listen, whether God gives you a prophetic word in your ears or not, the prophecy of scripture is valid. You can use the prophecy of scripture and prophesy to yourself, and it will happen the same way a prophet spoke to you. No matter how accurate what we say is, we still see in part. The word of God, scripture, must be exalted above every gift and every prophetic word. This becomes your comfort, that even though we may not have the time to mention everybody's name, and even if there is time, we do not have, the Bible says, though I speak with tongues of men and angels, though I understand all visions and all of that, we're limited. But it's for you to believe. Sir, I want to pray for you. Where are you coming from, sir?
I'm here in Abuja.
Abuja, here. Can I pray for you? God is lifting people. This is what I'm seeing. God is lifting people. God is showing me someone. You work in civil defense. It's time for your lifting. This is civil defense. Civil defense. Now, madam, you work in civil defense. I will pray for you, but is there anybody on the balcony that works in civil defense? This is what I'm seeing. This is a lady or not a man. Is there someone like that? Balcony, find out first. Where were you sitting? Come and stand. This is the place of encounter. Hallelujah. My dear, in the name of Jesus Christ, I don't care what is the issue that is on the table. According to the word of the Lord, if God could locate you, I declare, and I also pray for you, also civil defense, madam. I want to pray for you. Where are you from? I want to pray for you. In the name of Jesus Christ, you will come and stand, both of you. you will stand here before the people of God and you will testify of strange liftings in the name of Jesus. Receive that grace now by the power of the Holy Spirit. Sir, I pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ. Help her, please. Daddy, I don't know why you are standing outside here, but I want to pray for you. We are going to pray for the sick. I'm going to pray for you. Is it husband and wife? Madam, I need to pray because I hope you're not embarrassed, sir. Can I talk to you? Ah, we have to pray. I believe in miracles. God is taking sickness. Sickness. I'm looking at you and I'm seeing many things. I'm seeing a thermometer go up and down, up and down, up and down. This is BP. Two people will start running in the overflow outside. Outside. Now, we may not have time to bring them out. Outside. I'm seeing the power of God. Outside, the overflow outside. Just bring them to the front of the projector screen. I want to pray for them because the Lord is taking away the yoke of delay over those families. This is what the Lord is showing me. Sir, may my God bless you in the name of Jesus. And for you, sir, may my God, please stand up. You're a worker. What do you want God to do for you? Look at a wise man. You heard what he said? He said, I want to know him more. Is it not relationship that brought this privilege now? Don't you think relationship has other privileges too? The greatest prayer request is relationship. You can have a man's hand, but when you have his heart, you have access to everything. Are we together? And I truly pray that God will help you to know him more. The Holy Ghost that was given to us to help us know the Lord. But in addition to that, the fringe benefits of that relationship, let it speak in your life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I bless you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Every human agent in partnership with dark powers over your husband, madam, or over your wife, sir, or over your children, or over your parents, I bow my knees to the God of my covenant and I declare in the name of Jesus, that thing is destroyed now. Destroyed now. Destroyed now. Help them. Destroyed now. Please stand up. Let me tell you this. You see, one of the ways that God helps you to dispense the anointing is he plants compassion in you over the lives of people. This is somebody's father and grandfather. Now he's saying that, look, doctors are a miracle. They are instruments of God's mercy. Without them, we will not even live to even learn the ways of God. But look what is happening to this man now. We're about to pray for the sick shortly. I'm sure there's a reason why the Lord left him here. That he came together with our mother here, and now they are, I don't know what kind of surgery they are going to do now, but that he will never be able to speak again. Sir, come again.
Lord, that is either life or death.
Don't worry, madam. You are in the right place. You are a man of God here, please listen to me. You see the reason why we must keep contending for the anointing. It's not enough to say I'm Apostle Joshua Selman, I am this. Our alignment, there are destinies tied to our obedience. There are destiny tied to our prayer, our fasting, our diligence. The miracle that happens to this man and this family can bring many to Jesus. So no matter what level you are in ministry, please let this thing plant a genuine hunger. All these celebrity things that destroy us, push it one side and settle with God. Carry genuine fire, ever increasing fire. Yesterday's oil may not solve today's challenges. You will need fresh fire for the season. And if you are not ready to stay with God, don't ask God to give you members. What will you be doing with them? It's evil to ask people to come and gather people everywhere and then waste their time, share the grace and go back. Please don't be offended. I'm just sharing with you a passion. I'm looking at this man's situation. Daddy, we're going to pray for you. And I believe Jesus that he would do a miracle for you. I don't know what it is that he has put. And then God will heal you of BP, because I saw a thermometer going up and coming down. Can we pray for the sick now? In the name of Jesus. Please, no, stand up, sir. It's important. You see, I know that we live in very challenging times, and the devil has complicated matters by bringing all kinds of sicknesses on people. We had the miracle service in Zaria day before yesterday, and I was touched and broken when a woman came who had shown me they were doing dialysis for her. It's a family that is not well, very well to do. And then in the midst of it now, I'm not a doctor, but medical people will tell you here, I don't know how much it costs to do dialysis, but it's a very serious thing. Hallelujah. But Jesus still heals. Are we together? Now lay your hands very quickly, everyone. If it's a part of your body you cannot touch, just make contact with your chest.
He touched me. The Master touched me. And oh, what joy fills my soul. Something happened. And now I know he touched me and
me. There'll be a loud shout of a gentleman and a lady. The moment that shout happens, the healing power of Jesus will begin to move. A gentleman and a lady. Now we're ready to pray. Please, I'd like you to believe with a loud amen as I pray. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. My God, the healing anointing is flowing here. In the name of Jesus Christ. Every devil behind infirmities, you don't have to bring them out. Right now, miracles are happening. I command those devils to give way now. Give way now. Give way now. Now in the name of Jesus Christ, from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, be healed in Jesus' name. Be healed in Jesus' name. Migraine headaches, be healed in Jesus' name. Ulcers, be healed in Jesus' name. All kinds of growths and lumps around the body, I command them to disappear now. Bone conditions, be healed now. Those on crutches, those on wheelchairs, in the name of Jesus, be healed now. Be healed now. And you try to stand up, you're on a crutch, leave the crutch and start walking. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Deaf ears, partial deafness, complete deafness, be healed now. Blind eyes, open now. kinds of cancers and ulcers like our father here. Now I'm praying for you, sir. In the name of Jesus Christ, I stretch my hands to you, and then as a point of contact to everyone having any demonic death sentence, in Jesus' name, be healed now. Be healed now. The Lord is showing me people having severe abdominal problems, all kinds of abdominal problems here. The power of God is touching you right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. There's someone, what you have looks like what we call Parkinson's. I think I'm right. That thing that makes you to just shake, your body shakes. In the name of Jesus, I declare, may the power of the Holy Ghost touch you now. May the power of the Holy Ghost touch you now. Be healed in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ. I'm seeing a lady here. You don't have anything cancer, but your hair falls. This has been a very demonic thing. Right now, the power of God is touching you. Be healed now. Be healed now. Please don't. You are punishing this man. Just keep him somewhere. When he's healed, he can stand up and come. Huh? The man is trying to stand. Now, don't be embarrassed. I want to pray for you. You don't have to come out. The Lord is showing me a woman. You are not, what do you call it now? You are not a nursing mother, yet you are lactating. Now, I hope I know what I'm saying. Praise the Lord. But this is what is happening. In the name of Jesus Christ, let there be a miracle for you now. I don't know what the medical condition is, but in Jesus' name, we stop it now. There's someone, your left eye, you don't see very well with it. After this prayer, check it right now. A miracle is happening to you. I'm feeling pains here, literally, at the left side of my, what do you call this? Your kneecap. This is somebody's condition right now. The power of God is touching you. Supernatural miracle right now. Supernatural miracle right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Back pains, all kinds of back pains. In the name of Jesus Christ. Be healed now. The Lord is showing me at least 8 people. You have to take pills to sleep. You can't lie down normally and sleep. I think there's a medical condition. There's a name for it. You are not able to lie down and sleep. You must take a lot of drugs. One of you, the power of God is coming on you now. That demonic thing, we command it to live your life in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. And then I'm seeing someone. Until now, I think you have a problem with your shoulder. I don't know what it is. You cannot lift it. As soon as I pray, just lift it. Check yourself. Do what you cannot do. You'll be surprised that the power of God has touched you right now. Supernatural miracle. And then I'm seeing someone, you can't walk outside for a long time. You become unusually tired. You are not a very old person. But then you walk, no matter how, even if you rested the whole day, once you walk out just for a few minutes, you become extremely tired. The power of God is touching you now. No, you don't have to come out. You check yourself. When it's time to take miracles, we'll take them. In the name of Jesus Christ, I'm seeing multiple breast lumps. The Lord is healing them right now. Any stranger in your body that has not been planted by God, I command it to go out now. Hallelujah. I'm seeing you've been feeling like you are pregnant, but you are not pregnant, and yet it looks like the symptoms of pregnancy is with you, dear. This is a demonic thing. In the name of Jesus, I don't know who that kind of occurrence. You have dreams and you see all these ugly spirits come to molest you, and this thing, you feel as if you are pregnant physically, but then you are not really pregnant. In the name of Jesus, anyone in fraternity with dark powers that they are taking advantage of you to spy upon your liberty, I declare be released right now. Sugar diabetes, be healed now. Hepatitis, be healed now. The Lord is showing me someone. Is it that you fell down from a bed, or you fell down from a building or something, and your rib area is like you fell down right there, and from that day till now there's been severe pain around your rib area, but right now as I'm praying, the power of God is touching you. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Now, whether I mention your case or not, in the name of Jesus, be healed now. Please begin to pray and decree and declare, these Egyptians I see today, I see them no more forever. Please make sure you pray.
God of vengeance has fought my battle for me. God of miracles has won my battles for me. I'm a winner, man. I'm a winner, man. He has won my battle for me. I'm a winner, man.
I'm a winner, man. He has won my battles for me.
God of vengeance, God of vengeance has won my battles for me. God of miracles has won my battle for me. I'm a winner, man. I'm a winner, man.
Father, I want you to believe right now. The anointing you need for the results that your destiny needs to command, I pray for you. You don't have to bring those under the anointing outside now. In the name of Jesus, whether in ministry, whether in politics, in business, there are parliamentarians here, there are people from everywhere, there are business people, veterans in business, civil service, I pray the unction required for the next level of your results, I stand here and I declare, let it come upon you now. I decree and declare, you will check all these requests and you will not find any left. And the king sent for Joseph and they brought him out of his dungeon. Whoever must send for you in this season, I decree and declare, by the power that raised Christ from the dead, may the book of remembrance be open now. If there's anyone here that the spirit of death is trailing, or trailing your family members, whether death through the air, by sea, by land, in the name of Jesus, we speak to the spirit of death, you stay clear of them now. Hallelujah. Every long-standing issue that has refused to answer to the name of the Lord, I agree with you. In the name of Jesus Christ, let it be answered tonight. Hallelujah. Whatever has failed in your hands, in the name of Jesus, go back and succeed. Whatever has refused to walk in your hands, I declare, go back and succeed. For those of you in ministry, fresh fire for the new season. Those of you in business, fresh connections and illumination. Those in politics, parliamentarians, supernatural grace in the name of Jesus. And then I pray for your spiritual life. There is always an emphasis on our relationship with Jesus Christ, our passion and our hunger. I'm going to make the altar call shortly, but let me pray for your spiritual life. You go up today, you are down tomorrow. You pray today, then you ignore the prayer altar. You study today, then you ignore it. The grace for consistency. Take that grace now. Grace for prayer, fasting, word study, worship. May that grace rest upon you now. Can we pray over favor? Father, upon your people, the proof of favor is not just money. The proof of favor is loyalty to the hearts of men. I pray for you. Everybody who must consider you, in the name that is above all names, find favor with them. Find favor with systems. Find favor with structures. Find favor with government. Find favor with captains of industry. Find favor with gatekeepers. In the name of Jesus Christ. And everything you came with tonight as a point of contact, I declare by the Spirit of the Living God, whether it's a document, your credentials, whatever it is, I release my faith and I agree with you. Even as you have lifted it up, you remain lifted. In the name of Jesus Christ. Shame and reproach, we call it by name and we banish it from your life. In the name of Jesus Christ.
And everything sitting upon your prayer life to insist that you will not rise, in the name of Jesus and by the Spirit of the Christ, I clear it out of your life. I clear it out of your destiny. In the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord is showing me a door in the spirit, and this door has been closed for a long time, refusing to open. This is what I'm seeing. I truly believe that God is speaking about someone, a family, in the name that is above all names. I call upon he that holds the key of David, and I speak over every closed door, no matter how ancient, no matter how long, that has refused to open over your life, your ministry. In the name of Jesus, we command that door open now. 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 Take be open now. In the name of Jesus, open up Gita and Gita. Be open now. Hallelujah. Tonight is a very serious night. The Lord is opening my eyes in a vision. I'm seeing people standing, but I'm seeing their faces covered. This is what the Lord is showing me. Please, I want you to pay attention. Pay attention. The Lord brought us here to build us. You see, when the face of a man is covered in the realm of the spirit, number one, there can never be visibility for such a person. Number two, the doors of favor would be closed over that person. I'm going to minister the power of God, and I want you to bring those people out. Those at the overflows can just come to their projector stand. We need to tear off that veil. Now I stretch my hands, whether by the power of witchcraft or activities of ancestry, everything that is responsible, bring them out, that is causing your face that you will not be seen, is affecting your visibility in ministry. There are people in ministry
ministry here. You have integrity, you are walking in grace, but there is a veil over your face. There are businessmen, there are captains of industry right now, by the power of the Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus Christ. I declare for such people in this auditorium and outside, please bring them right now. May the fire of the Holy Spirit burn those veils right now. Burn those veils right now. Turn it into a prayer. Every veil covering the glory of God upon my life, it says, but thou, O Lord, art a shield for me. You are my glory. He called him the lifter up of my head. Bring them out. Everyone whose glory has been covered for no matter how long, you are immersed in the anointing of the Holy Ghost, and it must give way now. You came to church. This is the house of God. Lift your voice and pray. Thou, O Lord, art the shield for me. You are my glory. You are my glory. You are my glory. The lifter up of my head. The lifter up of my destiny. Elohim Adonai. Elohim Adonai. Still praying, hear me. Except God did not send me, if there is anyone under the sound of my voice, that there is any kind of yoke over your life, over your ministry, I stand by the rod of the apostolic, I stand by the rod of the prophetic, I declare judgment on strange spirits, judgment on foundation, judgment on yokes of darkness. Surely there is an end. Surely there is an end. Surely there is an end. Oh, I decree again in the realm of the spirit, let God's people go. I prophesy an exodus over your life from every realm of captivity. I'm saying it by the Spirit. I declare the power that will not let you go must let you go this night. Bring them out. The force that will not let you go. This is koinonia. The force that will not let you go. I stand by the God of heaven, the God of Jeshurun, that rides upon the wings of the wind. I declare it must let you go now. The Bible says, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. The Holy Ghost is ministering to me. There are people in business here. Every time good things are about to happen, there are forces, familiar spirits that stand to shut doors. I'm praying for business people. I stand by the unction of Jesus and I declare, anyone here in business, whatever power has refused to let you advance, in the name of Jesus, at the count of three, it comes under fire. One, two, three. Go, 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 go. Release your destiny. Release your businesses. In the name of Jesus Christ. It says, say unto God, how terrible art thou in your ways. It is through the greatness of thy power
that thy enemies submit themselves. Every long-standing infirmity in your body that will not let you go, hear me, I don't care what it is called, blood disease, genotype issues, recurrent things, eating your finances, destroying the destiny of your family, at the count of three you will shout Jesus and there will be a miracle of healing right now. All kinds of spirits that are at the back of mysterious infirmities, are you ready now? At the count of three, shout that name that is above every other name. 1, 2, 3, shout Jesus. Be healed. Be healed. Blood condition. Be healed. Heart condition. Be healed. Migraine. Be healed. All kinds of bodily infirmities. Let me pray one more prayer. Whoever is sitting on what is yours, between now and the end of this month, I stand by the God of heaven and by the spirit of prophecy. Please hear what I'm saying. Again, I repeat, whoever is sitting exchanging your destiny by the God of heaven, I declare, my God will uproot them. My God will uproot them. My God will uproot them. For all of you in front here, I decree and declare, standing for yourselves and your families, the spirits behind the mysterious tragedies of your life, I speak as one sent. Let them go now. Let them go now. Let them go now. Release their destinies now. They came to the house of God. Let them go now. By the power of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Who is this man? Come. What do you do, sir?
So I was into business, but nothing is moving.
You were into business?
Yes, sir.
I want to pray for you. I'm not a prophet of doom. This is the house of God. I'm looking at you and I'm seeing snakes from head to toe. This is what I'm seeing all around you. The Bible, this is the house of God. If we cannot solve problems supernaturally, we are wasting our time here. Sir, I'm saying it to you in the open by prophecy. The same way you are standing here, this is the same way you will stand here. Your life will change in a way that will surprise you. I stretch my hand. Take that grace. In the name of Jesus, let it open you to new dimensions. In the name of Jesus, every legal basis upon which the devil is oppressing you and your business, I come by the blood of Jesus and I declare it is over right now. Hallelujah. Who is Regina? Who is Regina? I'm hearing a name, Regina. You are wearing a yellow dress. Regina. Is there someone like that? Regina. Who is that? What's your name? Where are you coming from?
I'm coming from Jai here.
From where?
Jai.
You believe in Jesus?
Yes,
come,
sir.
Your family is about to experience a very strange miracle. Stand up. Listen, let me tell you this. Believe me when I tell you, people of God, there are people who are sent. There are people who are sent with an unction and sent with a grace. It is not the anointing that is available that blesses you. It's the anointing sent to you. Can I pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ, for you and for your family members right now? Every power that will not let you go, here in the house of God, I declare by the Spirit of God, a new chapter opens for your family now. A new chapter opens for your family now. Hallelujah. My friend, under the anointing, the Bible says the shouts of joy and victory shall not depart from the tent of the righteous. Therefore, I speak to you, everything that has stolen away your joy and your testimony as a family, I command it to let you go now. In the name of Jesus. Let me pray. Miscarriage, I want to pray. Don't worry, I'll pray for you. Wherefore God had so highly exalted him and given him a name, something is coming on your wife. It's over now. Now, two of you, over now. I'm seeing a spirit that is back of her miscarriage. I challenge you by the God of heaven, let her go now. Let me pray for you. Father, I stretch my hands. I'm seeing fire leaving my hands and just coming on you. Everything that will not let you be fruitful is a command. Whatever will want you to disobey that command, I open up your wombs in the name of Jesus, and according to the time of life, I decree and declare, return with your miracle children. Regardless the medical report, we stand by the God of heaven and we declare, oppression in the area of fruitfulness come to end now in the name of Jesus Christ.
Hiya, hiya, yeah, yeah. Your life will never be the same. My life must change. I will never be the same. Your life must change.
That's why you're here.
Your life must change. Your life must change.
Your life must change.
Your life must change.
Your life.
For some of you,
your home must change.
Your home must change.
Your home must change.
Your home must change.
Your job 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 must change. Of the living God. Hey, la das pele katabranda hasiba katasya. We believe in you. We believe in your grace. We believe in your power. This is Mount Zion, the city of our God, the dwelling place of his power. I'd
like you to lift your voice in 1 minute and cry for a visitation tonight. Let it be from the depth of your heart. Don't look around. Forget about who is by your left and right. Cry to the God of our salvation. Give me an encounter tonight in the name of Jesus. For everyone that has get received. Atapakato Shelekem Prataska Telekata Embrekete Shelekete Pakatapakatos Yata. Are you praying? Everyone that has them, receive it. La telekete parakato patu, prete patu, jatekete prendekete parato sondo bakata, prete paru zina kata prendekete paruto sondo balakata parikata, kete parente kete paruto sondo prendekete, kete pakata parato kata prendekete prendekata, kete parente kete parato kata parato. Pray, you're enlarging your capacity to receive it. You will never be the same. This is the house of God. You will never be the same.
My deliverer is coming. My deliverer is standing by.
There's a reason why I'm raising this song.
Your deliverer is coming. Your deliverer is standing by. Your deliverer is coming. Your deliverer is standing by.
But the Lord is opening my eyes. I saw chains on the feet of people. That's why I raised this song. I'm seeing the number 23. I stretch my hands. Anyone under the influence of this unction, and there is a chain of darkness holding you, at the count of three, I want you to shout Jesus. Inside and outside, I want you to bring them here. In the name that is above all names, this is Mount Zion. And the Bible declares that upon Mount Zion, there shall be deliverance. Are you ready to shout? One, two, three, shout Jesus. I break chains. I break chains. Bring them out. I break chains. Every chain that will not let you move forward, every chain that holds you down, it must leave you now. In the name of Jesus, the Christ of God, bring them out. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Please just lay your right hand on your head. Just do what I'm asking you to do. Please be silent. No instrument, no nothing. Just lay your right hand on your head. I'm just seeing fire move from person to person. Just bring those under the anointing outside. There is a massive deliverance. I'm seeing horns. And the Lord is telling me that these are ancient altars that are sitting on families that will not let them go free. Some of you, it's been so for long. But except God did not send us, I tell you, those altars will not last today's service. Just keep your hands on your head. Father, in the name of Jesus, anyone under the sound of my voice, in here, the overflows, outside, following online, if there is any handwriting and any altar, pateke barata, bring them outside. On anyone's destiny, on anyone's life, those altars catch fire right now. Keep your hands on your head. Release that family, all of them.
Release that family. Not just one person. Release that family. This is a whole family under bondage. Release them. Release them. Release them now. Release them now. Father, mother, siblings, release them. In the name of Jesus, I'm seeing a family no one gives birth. Fruitfulness is a challenge. The Lord is releasing that family right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. This is koinonia. Every manifestation of wisdom, exchanging the glory of anyone here, so that where you should be, another is taking your place. I command that spirit to give way right now in the name of Jesus. I command that spirit to give way in the name of Jesus. This change that I see on people's feet, it's time to release them right now. You've been at the same position for many years. The only thing growing in your life is your age. Nothing more is growing. In the name of Jesus, I take authority over it. I take authority over it. Hallelujah. Who is Bethel? I'm hearing a name, Bethel. Bethel. We'll be seated shortly. But this is the house of God. Bethel. In the name of Jesus Christ. Madam. I don't know who this woman is. Yes, that one with her hand on her head. Madam, look at me. I'm seeing oil being poured on your head. And the Lord is saying a major breakthrough is coming to your family. That things will never be the same. You don't have to bring her out. What's your name? Is she the Bethel? What's, you are Bethel, madam? Let me pray for you. There is a Bethel that the Lord is asking me to rebuke death from your family, because I am seeing obituary by the month of May, and the Lord is saying we must rebuke that spirit. Hear me, anyone that digs a pit for you here, I declare the earth will open and swallow them. The Bible says, and the Lord of peace shall give you peace always and by all means. In the name of Jesus, I pray for you. All of the Bethels who are here, I stretch my hands and I declare that the plague of death is over from your life and your family. We minister life by the Spirit of grace in the name of Jesus Christ. And for all of you who are out here by the Spirit, I open up every closed door right now. And in the name of Jesus, we release you to prophetic dimensions. Move to the next levels of your life, next levels of your destinies. In the name of Jesus Christ. Ah, one more time. Whatever will not let you go, I call on my God, who is also your God. May he clear them out of the way. May he clear them out of your way. May he clear them out of your way. Every obstacle that will not let you advance, I call on my God to clear them out of your way. Genesis 28, we'll start from verse 10. The blessing is in verse 13 to 15. Please pay attention. The Bible says, and Jacob went out from Beersheba and went towards Haran. And he lighted upon a certain place and tarried there all night. The Bible says, because the sun was set, he took stones from that place and put them for pillows
and he lay down in that place to sleep. And he dreamed, and behold, a ladder was set on the earth, and the top of it reached the heaven. And behold, the angels of God ascending and descending on it. Are you ready for the blessing? And behold, verse 13 says, the Lord stood above it and said, I am the Lord God of Abraham thy father, and the God of Isaac. The land whereupon thou liest, to you I will give unto you and your seed. Verse 14, it says, your seed shall be as the dust of the earth. And thou shall spread abroad to the west, and to the east, and to the north, and to the south. It says, and in thee and in thy seed shall all the families of the earth be blessed. Verse 15, and behold, I am with thee, and I will keep thee in all places whither thou goest, and I will bring thee again into this land, for I will not leave thee until I have done that which I have spoken unto you.
Mando protocos complete que te le pongo tu presca de banana 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 banana. Shekata prekata de bokoria de banana. Hallelujah. Just three prayer points quickly. Prayer point number one. I like you to pray and say, Lord, I receive your word and I will run with it this year. Lift your voice and begin to pray. Lord, I receive it. I receive your word as a believer. I receive your word. Shekabakata la poko soto preach. Mandeka la cross kada brenda kaparia da bash. Are you praying, Koinonia? Lord, we receive your word. Shempre tos koto prakata balada bash. But I know whom I have believed, and I am persuaded. I am persuaded that he is able. He is able. Kapaka pros katabana da bosh rekatete kaposho pros kopariya da ba embre tos kone pros kataba lekatete pros koto bakariya da ba da ba empros kotosh kopres kene bokoto ba de pros sekete kene ba soto bakariya da ba da ba empros kete ne koto pres kini ba 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 ba. Hallelujah. 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 Prayer point number two. Lord, make me addicted to your presence this year, that I will seek you, I will seek your word, I will seek prayer, I will seek your presence. Lift your voice and pray. Lift your voice and pray. Oh, sheke pakata la bakate. Lord, I seek you this year like never before. Like never before. I seek you with all my heart, all my might, all my soul. Pray. Revival to my prayer life. Revival to my word study life. Give me encounters, oh God. Supernatural visitations this year. Dreams, visions, encounters with the power of the Holy Ghost that will take me to a new dimension in the spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. prayer point number three, Lord, this year will be a year of results. I must hold on to tangible evidences. Lift your voice. Results. This must be a year of results. Outside, are you praying? This must be a year of results. There must be proofs in my life. There must be evidences in my life. Miracles, signs, wonders, the demonstration of the power of God, the demonstration of the word of God in my life, in my ministry, pray, in my business, in my education, in my family, there must be results. There must be results in the name of Jesus. There must be results in the name of Jesus. There must be results in the name of Jesus. There must be results in the name of Jesus. There must be results. Hallelujah. The Bible says, let your light shine before men that they may see it. When men see, there is a level of notable results. You can argue all kinds of things, but you can't argue results. It says that they may glorify your Father in heaven. Please, I want you to pray this with all your heart. Father, connect me to influential relationships this year. Just pray what I'm asking you to pray. Lift your voice. Connect me to men of influence across different strata. Men who will allow me ride on their success. Men who will allow me ride on their anointings. Men who will allow me ride on their influence. Men who will endorse me. Pray. Shekete koto sekete. Oh, send down help to Zion, O great one. In the name of Jesus, send down help to your people. Supernatural connections that will give you in one day the labor of other people's lifetime. Men of influence in every mountain. Men of influence in the government. Men of influence in finance. Men of influence in the educational realm. Oh God, that in every area, raise men to stand for me, raise men to speak for me, raise men to advocate for me. Make my life easy this year. Pray, make my life easy this year. As I serve you, let there be ease in my life. I rise upon the influence of many. I rise upon the strength of quality relationships, uncommon access, uncommon doors, uncommon resources, uncommon encounters. Hallelujah. I want to prophesy over your life. Please, I want you to believe it. Believe it. Many of us ignore the power of prophecy to our detriment. Listen, you don't, God created provision. You don't have to struggle your way by yourself. There are people that have been put strategically to help you. You can reject the help to your detriment. There are people who have traveled far and near. There are whole families in this place. Travel distances and hours just to come. Some of you are within reach, yet you will not open up your heart. Don't let people come and receive their blessings and go back, and you are there. Just make up your mind. The Bible said, by a prophet the Lord brought Israel out of Egypt. He said, by a prophet they were preserved. It's not human worship. There may be exaggerations here and there, but it does not mean prophecy is powerful. It can frame your reality. Please, I want you to believe it. Prophecy is very powerful. This is the crux of the meeting tonight, because it will give you direction. Listen, let me tell you how prophecy works. Look up. I know our time is gone, but let me just use one example. Come, anybody. Prophecy is like a charm. Listen, when it is spoken, it leaves as I'm speaking. It's like a charm. It comes upon you and creates an effect. It makes things that should not have happened happen. Listen, I told you, the most superior dimension of the prophetic is not the revelatory dimension. The creative dimension of the prophetic is the most superior dimension. The revelatory dimension is important. It gives you direction and builds faith. But the creative dimension is what is responsible for creating your reality. I prophesied as I was commanded. He said, and there was a sound. It's not like the sound was wrong. It was never there. Prophecy called it. Prophecy calls things that be not as though they are. Lift your hands as I speak over your life. Father, let there be results in the name of Jesus. In the name that is above all names, I speak unto you an unusual anointing that will step you into encounters with the Holy Ghost. Receive it right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Listen, a dimension of unction that you have never functioned in the name that is above all names. I prophesy that this year you will ride upon a river, an unction that will take you to superior levels in the spirit. Oh, I command it to be so in the spirit. I command it to be so in the spirit. I pray for you. The mark of favor that can come upon a man and produce uncommon access, in the name that is above all names, may that mark come upon your life right now. I prophesy to you, may that mark come upon your life right now. May that mark come upon your life right now. Listen, honor is an anointing. There is an anointing that can come upon a man and make him honorable. He says, and Jabez was more honorable. That anointing that makes men honorable, I release it upon you right now. Receive that anointing for honor, uncommon honor. God will position men to celebrate your grace. They will appreciate you. They will sow into your grace. I pray for you this year. May the spirit of revelation, illumination and insight into the mysteries and the oppression of the kingdom, I release it upon you right now. Oh,
eyes to see, eyes to see. I release it upon you. Uncommon dimension of access to spiritual realities. I release it upon you like a mantle in the name of the Lord Jesus.
My goodness, there are strange impartations, strong impartations that are happening to people by the anointing of the Holy Ghost. By the anointing of the Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus, I release impartations of this unction, the spirit of revelation, strange levels of access in the spirit. I open to you fountains, fountains of light in the spirit. I open you up to mysteries. I open you up to mysteries in the name of Jesus. I open you up to mysteries, strange operation of mysteries. Hallelujah. Hear me. Every person who you must connect to rise, wherever they are, is called a year of multiplied influence. I'm prophesying to you, please believe me, from the north to the south, the east and the west, every anointing, every grace you must connect to rise, I release access to you in the name of Jesus. Access to people, access to anointings, access to opportunities in the name of Jesus. Oh, connect with influential people. I release that anointing upon you. Receive it. Connect to influential people. Receive it right now. Influence, influence. I stand upon this apostolic office and I prophesy supernatural influence. Connect to people in government. Connect to people everywhere. In the name of Jesus, they will listen to you when you speak. They will rise up to help you.
Rise up for you. Every door that refused to open in the name of Jesus, under this multiplied grace, we compel that door to open in the name of Jesus. Every door that refused to open, every obstacle that refused to let you go, right now in the name of Jesus, I command that door open now. Open now. Hear me. I prophesy to your loved ones, this year we force results in your family. Hear me again. This year we command results in your family. May the angel that has been assigned to Koinonia, the angels that have been dispatched to honor this prophetic word, may they go to every family and begin to cause the word of God to come alive. Listen, some of you, it will not reach 24 hours, your result will start coming. Believe me, it will not reach 24 hours, your results will start coming. Dramatic results. Listen, Koinonia, you will hear testimonies this year that will make you afraid. People will come and stand here and you will think they are lying because of the breakthrough upon breakthrough upon breakthrough. Receive it in the name of Jesus Christ. I bless the work of your hands this year. May an anointing come upon it in the name of Jesus. For students, I pray a level of grace and ease that you have never seen, a level of superior intelligence. I release it upon you right now. I release it upon you right now. Listen, this is the year of Jubilee, and I prophesy to you the opening of gates to every age-long challenge. Prophetically and even historically, This is the season of Jubilee, and in the season of Jubilee, you let go captives. I command every captivity in this season of Jubilee, it must let you go right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. For we rise to our access to mysteries in the kingdom. I want to pray for you, but we're going to pray one more prayer point. Hear me. The Bible says, the scripture we started in. Give us that scripture again, Lamentations 5 verse 7. Please quickly, we want to pray and then we'll round up. Lamentations chapter 5 verse 7. Our fathers have seen and are not, and we have borne their iniquities. But now, if I appropriate the revelation that I have been called out of every tribe, out of every tongue, out of every nation, I can't go to hell because I was born in Kogi or I was born in Plateau State. I didn't ask them to do witchcraft. And now that they have done it, if the land is cursed, I exempt myself. I can't be a victim of another man's wickedness. Listen, I'd like you to pray with all your heart and say, I begin a new order, a new order, dissociated from the past, alienated from the witchcraft and curses and yokes by the blood of the eternal covenant. Koinonia, are you praying? Alienated every biological deformity, every genetic deformity. Pray every yoke that made you SS, that made you AS, that gave you hepatitis.
Lift your hands, I want to pray for you. This is our year of triumph. Now thanks be to God who causes us always to triumph. I want to pray for you. Listen, let me tell you, if God be God, everything that you are carrying, I don't care whether it's self-inflicted, you have invoked the blood. The blood provokes the compassion of the Christ. His advocacy at the throne of the Father does not happen automatically. It happens in response to an incense sent from the earth. The same way his high priestly ministry, the Bible says, is in the order of Melchizedek. Melchizedek did not speak until he had an encounter with Abraham and he gave him a tenth of all. I want to pray for you now, because there are lives and destinies under the yoke of witchcraft. Koinonia remains an uncomfortable place for them until it shall come to pass in that day that the burden shall be lifted from off your neck and the yoke from off your shoulder, and it shall be destroyed because of the anointing. Yes. I stretch my hands right now. Hear me. I'm hearing in my spirit household wickedness, and the fire of God is falling upon all who are victims of that. I stretch my hands right now. Let it be. Shabbos kupadabash. Lekretete toko soto balakata. Shabrekete kosuta bariakata. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Inside, outside, I stretch my hands. Be free right now. Be free right now. In the name of Jesus, be free right now from activities of witchcraft. Hallelujah. Demonic activities
strangers coming to you in the night to sleep with you, men, women, animals, and all kinds of things coming to destroy you, plant rubbish in your body. I pray right now in the name of Jesus, anyone who is a victim of every kind of manipulation in dreams caused as a result of ancestry, right now in the name of Jesus, I command freedom, I command liberty, I command freedom, I command liberty. The blood speaks right now in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ. He said, the earth is cursed for your sake. He says, with the sweat of your brows shall you eat. But the Bible says in Galatians chapter 3 verse 29, he says, and if ye be Christ's, then are ye Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise. I want to speak and set you free. There is a curse of hardship. Many people are victims of this curse. Hardship has nothing to do with poverty. Listen carefully. Many people here, you are standing representing your families as I pray. And right now, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, the Son of the Living God, I stretch my hands right now. I command that yoke be taken from off your shoulder. Help them, please. Be taken from off your shoulders. Be taken from off your shoulders. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I command that curse of hardship be taken from off your shoulders. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hear me, I declare to you, a dimension of ease you have never seen in your life. Step into it right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yoke of disfavor, bad luck that looms around the life of men and women here, so that you never rise, is like a veil on your face, and anyone who sees you walks against you. I command that veil be taken off right now, be taken off right now, be taken off right now, in the name of Jesus Christ. And Cain said, my punishment is too great. He said, I have become a fugitive and a vagabond. He said, all who see me will slay me. All who see me will slay me. All who see me will slay me. Whether they are strangers, something upon me makes all who see me to slay me. Any mark, seketo shalakras katabadiasha, lebrente keskotabras kataria. Any mark upon your life, upon your business, upon your ministry that keeps attracting walls, keeps attracting scandals, keep attracting negativisms, right now in the name of Jesus, that mark be blotted forever. Be blotted forever. Be blotted forever. Any strange sickness in your body through your blood that came from ancestry, genotypes, SS, Shakatosia, AS. There's no such reality in the realm of the spirit. That provision does not exist. It's a manipulation from the second heavens, altering the genetics of men. But right now, in the name of Jesus, every blood-related issue passed to you by covenant, I blot it out of your body right now. I blot it out right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The
classic sign of curses and yokes is the presence of patterns. You usually are not the first to experience that, but I want to prophesy right now. I don't know what patterns you have seen around your life, you have seen around your finances, you have seen around your walk with God. You are up today, down tomorrow. You are serious today, unserious tomorrow. You love the Lord today, you love something else tomorrow. Your ministry rises today, crashes tomorrow. Your finances is up today and is blown like the wind. In the name of Jesus. The Bible says every house is built by some man, but God is the builder. Therefore I decree and declare that any pattern, any spiritual construction that was built by an agency other than the Christ, in the name that is above all names, I command a tearing down and a rebuilding now. 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 I announce to the realm of the spirit, whatever should have happened to your life by now for good, but because of the presence of these embargoes, there are dimensions you should have entered in Christ. There are levels of growth, levels of advancement and influence and wisdom and access that you should have been a custodian of by grace, and for whatever reason, certain objections have risen in the realm of the spirit to stop you. In the name of Jesus Christ, I provoke restoration right now. 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 I pray over your life. And the hand of the Lord came upon Elijah, and the Bible says Elijah ran on barefoot and overtook the chariots of Ahab down to Jezreel. I want to speak speed in your life. I don't know what tied you down. By now, according to the program of God for you, you should have entered certain levels. You should have been the mother of four children now, but you are yet to have one. Therefore, I command speed. Step into it right now. In the name of Jesus, I command speed. Speed of accomplishment. Speed of accomplishment. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. For there is an unction that can come on a man. There is an anointing that can produce an outcome that is not available in the earth. There is an anointing that is called the breaker anointing, the yoke destroying. There is such a provision in the kingdom to not only be set free, but to be a possessor of a spiritual substance that is capable of causing everyone within the influence of your grace to come under the influence of the liberty that you possess. It's an anointing. There is a provision in the dealings of God with men where men can carry atmospheres that have prophetic implication to all those who come within the circumference of that atmosphere. You will not have the time to pray for everybody, but you can carry a climate. I want to release a grace and unction upon your life that you will go back home, you will go back to regions, you will go back to places, you will enter your room. There are physical territories that are caused, but like Mara, the water, you will pick it, and in the name of Jesus, you will change that situation. Like the, listen, the Bible says that the prophets were eating and they said, there is death in this food, and he said, bring me flour, and he put it and said, go ahead and eat. There is an ability, there is an unction that can veto the plans of darkness. In the name of Jesus, wherever you are, like a mantle,
May that anointing come upon your life right now. Soto sota leke tosketerika, a breaker anointing. The grace and the unction, carry the fire, carry the grace, carry the unction. Command deliverance, make environments cost free in the name of Jesus. May your presence, your presence in your home, your presence in your office, your presence in your ministry sustain an ability to nullify ordinances, nullify yokes and curses and enchantments. Surely they shall gather, but because their gathering is not of God, there is a substance you possess that will disengage everything that is of God. Receive it now in the name of Jesus. I declare that from now, step into a season of joy and laughter. Step into a season of joy and laughter. It says, you have turned my mourning into dancing, my sorrow to joy. I call to end the days of sorrow. I call to end the days of mourning. I appoint unto you a new season of laughter. In the name of Jesus, whatever represents stagnation in your life that will not let you move forward, I break you from whatever is stopping your advancement. I break you from whatever is stopping your advancement. And in the name of Jesus, go forward. In the name of Jesus, go forward. In your career, go forward. In ministry, go forward. In business, go forward. In your academics, go forward. Hallelujah.
Look at Jesus. Face to face.
Can you lift your hands to Jesus, the Son of the Living God, and just bless him tonight? Let him know that you are here because you love him. Let him know that you are here because there is a longing in your heart for more and more and more of him. Someone express your desperation, your hunger and your thirst. We desire to know you. We desire to know you. We desire to know you. We desire to know your ways, to access your wisdom. We desire to live for you and to love you all the days of our lives. Hallelujah. John chapter 17 and verse 3 says, "And this is life eternal, that they may know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ whom thou hast sent." One more time, I'd like you to pray from the depth of your heart, that my everything cries for you. Lord, I pray that you give me an encounter tonight. My everything cries for you. Pali shaba sobrande gebalatos. You are my life. You are my relevance. You are my hope. I build my life and my destiny upon you. I trust you with my life. I trust you with my everything. Give me an encounter tonight. Lift me up, take me higher, let me encounter your presence, your spirit afresh. For in Jesus' name we pray. For in Jesus' name we pray.
He
The next 5 minutes is a serious time of prayer. Please, no carelessness. Focus on Jesus. Minimize moving up and down. And let's pray. Because I want to speak and release some graces upon your life. I'd like you to pray. Whether you are seated, whether you are standing, whether you are lying on the floor. I just want you to take some time and pray in the spirit in 1 minute. Go ahead and pray. Shades kabadakata paranda gelekosiata rata badaga debelekatos. Those who are watching online, make sure you are connecting. If you are alone, pray. Jesus is there. This is a destiny defining moment. Kate prakate belekata praska varatos ebrakata pareska pelanto shalabaratos yata. Shataska tefreska teberente kepras. Ombra kata barakata freska tebelekates. Kebrende ketebelekatosh. Lika parasa baranda barekate lekaso zediata. Krapata kata brete keberetusiates. Pray. It's a new season for you. The glory of the Lord is rising upon you. Someone pray. It does not matter that you are coming from that lonely estate. The hand of His Majesty lifting you by His Spirit, revealing you. You are an effulgence of the glory of the Lord. That through your life, people will learn God afresh. Through your life, they will see the excellency of the power and of the wisdom of the Spirit. Ate praska da beleketo sofra tegebash. Ranta parasa praska bereska teleko shadis. Ekratike berene begeta soto proto segetesh. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We're still praying. Father, what area of revelation in my life is deficient? Open my eyes to see it. Go ahead and pray. What area? Is it my finances? Is it that I do not understand the dynamics of excelling in my spiritual life? Is it that I do not understand the wisdom of living and exerting dominion over the cosmos? Open my eyes, O God, that I may behold wondrous things. Call unto me and I will answer. I will show you great and mighty things which thou knowest not. The principles that make for character, the principles in the name of Jesus, the engracing that brings total freedom and liberty over curses, over yokes, over diabolic manifestations. Reveal, reveal by your spirit. Reveal by your spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The last prayer point you are going to pray before I speak over your life. You know the area of needs that you have. That you know when God steps in and it is sorted, it will truly give you the time to sort the king. Some of you maybe is housing. Some of you maybe is sorting out certain material things. The Bible says, ye have not because ye ask not. It says, hitherto you have not asked for anything. It says, ask and you shall receive, that your joy may be full. I want you to open your mouth and unashamedly ask God. It is the Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Lord, sort this area of my life, that I will have the liberty to serve you. Go ahead and pray. Go ahead and pray. Go ahead and pray. Your marriage, your finances, your children, your basic needs, your family, cry unto the God of heaven. Unto thee that answers prayer shall all flesh come. Shabraska tebelekatoska prandege barusesieta. Ekrateka tebekatoska tebelekosh. Rest roundabout. In the name of Jesus. Someone is praying. Someone is praying. A businessman is praying. In the name of Jesus. A career person is praying. Someone who is in need for employment is praying. A man of God is praying, a prophet in the making, an apostle in the making. Pray from the depth of your heart. Let the maker of men make your life, sort your life, bring you rest. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When your needs are met, I assure you that you will have the time to serve His Majesty. A lifetime is too long to have your needs met. A lifetime was designed to serve the King, not serve things, not look for things. Looking for things for the rest of your life is an erroneous use of destiny. Hallelujah. What you are about to receive is the engracing that now makes the things that you have learned. It says, now that ye know these things, if all I do is to leave you at the point of just discussions and knowledge, then I did not do you much. For every time God speaks, there is an engracing. The assignment of that grace is to rest upon you and to cause the things that you have heard to give you the impetus, the propelling force to move in obedience and to partner with your obedience to make manifest the things that you have believed. That is the assignment of the anointing. The assignment of the grace of God that follows His word is to back to propel you, number one, to obey, and then in obeying to partner with your obedience now to make manifest the things that you have believed. You are the covenant keeping God. You are the covenant keeping God. Yahweh,
covenant-keeping God. Yahweh, covenant-keeping God. You are covenant-keeping God. You are covenant-keeping God.
Listen, as I speak over you, I want you to shake away that lie that the devil has told you will never rise. I want you to shake away that demonic belief. Just because you came from the village, shake away that demonic belief. Apostle, I've lived a wayward life, I've lived a scattered life. Do not worry. In His presence, there is room for restoration. But I want to pray for you. I want you to receive from the depth of your heart. I stretch my hands towards you and I decree and declare, I call upon the God who helps men, the one who helps men to rise, the one who helps men to thrive. In the name of Jesus Christ, begin to command strange results from tonight. Begin to command strange results from tonight. Strange results from tonight. Extraordinary results from tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for your passion for the things of God. Your passion for the things of the Spirit. Fresh fire upon your altar. Fresh fire upon your altar. Fresh fire upon your altar. Now hear me. I want you to receive this prayer. I want to pray for you. There are many of you, I'm saying it prophetically, between now and December, you will stand here to dedicate your own home. I say it by the God who sent me, in the name of Jesus Christ. And for some of you, as it is now, you may not even have work to do. But you see, God is ever willing to make His power manifest. I say it again, by His favor, may God start sorting your personal needs. Please hear me. For some of you, while I described the human body, I perhaps called systems that are physically failing in your own body. While it was an analogy to explain the kingdom systems for victory, for some of you, you were just wondering and saying, Apostle is just calling this thing. Anything that has entered your body and has vowed to cut short your life, I command it must jump out of your body now. It must jump out of your body now. It must jump out of your systems, out of your organs, now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm going to speak over your finances. If you don't need it, you can receive it for someone else. But I want to pray over your finances. There is an advantage we have in addition to our value, our wisdom, relationships. There is the grace of God that engenders favor. You find that in 2 Corinthians chapter 9 and verse 8. I like how the Bible puts it. It says, and God is able to make all grace, not some grace, all grace abound towards you, that ye always, having all sufficiency. Sufficiency means the capacity to always rise to the occasion, never disappointing. In all things, it says, may abound to every good work. I decree and declare, in the name of Jesus, the Son of the living God, for someone here, regardless the financial mountains that stand before you, I call upon my God, who is also your God. Let things begin to change supernaturally. Open financial doors. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ. It says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. I decree and declare, whatever makes resources to go out of your hands, whether it's the careless use of them or a demonic manipulation, whatever be the case, I decree and declare, the grace to retain resources, receive it now. Are you ready for favor? I will pray this one today. I will pray it at the miracle service next week. I will continue to pray it till you become a living expression of the favor of God. Let me pray it for you. What is in favor? Favor has the ability to accelerate your life and your destiny. Favor has the supernatural ability to bring to end seasons of hardship, seasons of all kinds of things. Most people have not understood the all-surpassing excellency of carrying the genuine grace for favor. And I have told you, the proof of favor is not money. Money is the least thing you can be given as a result of favor. The proof of favor is when God connects you to the hearts of men, that you call on one man and a nation is ready to respond to you and even to attend to your needs. I don't know who that person is, but I'm stretching my hands towards you. That grace, I lay my hands on my own head and I pray, by the privilege of the election of grace, may that grace rest upon you. May that grace rest upon you. Rest upon you. Rest upon you. This grace called favor, let it rest upon you. Let it rest upon you. In the city, in the country, let it rest upon you. In the name of Jesus Christ, that you become a living evidence of what God can do with men. In the name of Jesus Christ. And by this impartation of favor, I call forth whoever has been mandated by God to participate in your rising. Whether you know them or not, I declare this week, by the power that raised Christ from the dead, may they show up in your life. May they show up in your life. in the name of Jesus Christ. Hear me. Final prayer. Whatever has refused to move forward, you have moved it by your energy, you have moved it intellectually, you have outsourced men to move it, but it has refused to move. I stand by the advantage of the prophetic. I move you forward. I move you forward. Make constructive progress in the name of Jesus Christ. For in Jesus' name we pray. You have believed it, your eyes will see it, your hands will handle it. I say it again, your eyes will see it and your hands will handle it. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus, the Son of the living God, I decree and declare that you return next week a sign and a wonder. This week beginning, I declare over your life that every mountain and every challenge that has stood before you, every issue of concern that you came here with, in the name of Jesus, that mountain falls like Dagon before the ark. All those who are traveling to various locations this week, we declare your journey is blessed. You are blessed in your office. You are blessed in the place of assignment. Your families are blessed. Our children here in this ministry are blessed. In the name of Jesus. As a nation, we confer the blessing of the Lord upon this nation. And we declare no bad news, no evil report. In the name of Jesus Christ.
No eye has seen, no ear has heard what God has prepared for me.
Here's the prayer.
So I submit to his work in me till Christ be formed in me. No eye has seen, no ear has heard what God has prepared for me. So I submit to his work in me, Christ.
Are you ready to pray this second prayer? Lord, the circumcision that must happen to me to be able to host the new that you are bringing, that circumcision of the flesh, that circumcision in my heart, Lord, let it happen. Expand me. Everything that needs to be done in my life to carry these superior levels of grace, prosperity, wisdom, influence, access, let it happen. Someone is praying. You are a kingdom financier, pray. It is not just give me, give me, give me. Your first prayer is make me. Make me before give me. Don't just pray and say give me billions. No, this version of you will be an ineffective and inefficient steward. Walk upon my heart so that my hands will be faithful. Walk upon my heart so that my bank account will be faithful. Walk upon my heart so that my sermons will be accurate. Walk upon my heart so that the results will be authentic. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I stretch my hands over you by the power that raised Christ from the dead. Be delivered now. Be delivered now. Be delivered now. I speak to you in the name of Jesus, like Prophet Eli spoke over Hannah. According to I'm seeing fire. This is what I'm seeing. I'm just seeing fire move over people. Satan, the Lord rebuke you. Release them now. Release them now. Release them now. Release them now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Release them now. I stand in partnership with the Holy Ghost and I declare, be fruitful. Be fruitful. Be fruitful. The Lord gave it as a command. We stand as a ministry and enforce it over your life. And as I'm praying for these ones, anyone in the congregation who is trusting God for the miracle of fruitfulness, paruska tapakata, fire is falling in the name of Jesus. I declare, be fruitful. Be fruitful. Whatever the medical condition is, we veto it by the word of God. And we declare, according to the time of life, go and return with your children. And for those of you trusting God for twins, in the name of Jesus, we release twins. Those of you trusting God for triplets, in the name of Jesus, we release triplets. You will think it's a joke till you stand to dedicate them here. So shall it be. In the name of Jesus. There is one of you here, I'm seeing a spirit always appears to you. And this is something that also happened to your sister. They tell you they have visions where wicked spirits appear to them. Who is that person? In the name of Jesus, I decree and declare, every foul devil that will not allow you enjoy your marriage, in the name of Jesus, we declare a separation right now. A separation right now.
If you're healing someone in this nation, don't do it without me. Don't do it without me. Lord, if you're lifting nations in this season, don't do it without me. Lord, if you're blessing nations in this city, wherever you want to go, Lord, you can go through me. Whoever you want to lift, Lord, you can lift through me. Whatever you want to say, Lord, you can say through me. Whoever you want to change,
Father, we hold our hands as a family of faith and we declare that we remain ever available. We thank you for showing us profound mercy. You have singled us out as a people and you have chosen to honor us. Not just the week past, you have invested your honor and your grace upon our lives. And Lord, we declare, I declare on behalf of your people that we have chosen to be on the Lord's side. In the name of Jesus Christ, we declare that you grant unto us as individuals and as a ministry longevity of impact. In the name of Jesus Christ. And Lord, we pray that everything that can become a distraction to our kingdom pursuit, let it be far from us. Lord, I'm praying for someone, I'm praying for a family that may be discouraged right now. Looks like you have not seen a performance of the word of God. You have celebrated as a global family, but individually, you are yet to see certain results. I agree with you. Because you are now determined to be on the Lord's side, may the power that is on the Lord's side work for you. May the wisdom that is on the Lord's side work for you. May the speed that is on the Lord's side work for you. May the immunity that is on the Lord's side work for you. May the restoration that is on the Lord's side work for you. In the name of Jesus Christ. This week I declare over your life, by the power that raised Jesus from the dead, return with results. This will be a week of strange evidences in your life. Whatever it takes to be fruitful, whatever it takes to be a worthy ambassador, I empower you with it right now in Jesus' name. And I rebuke the hand of Satan over your life in the name of Jesus Christ. That by tomorrow, even up until next week, you will return with strange testimonies. I declare protection over you. I declare preservation over you. I command favor upon your life. Your prayer life will never go down. Your word study life will never go down. Supernatural revelation by the Spirit. Let the mantle of honor rest on you. Shame and reproach is far from your life. You indeed will show yourself as a people that God has helped. In the name of Jesus Christ. Wave your hands to Jesus and give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name, the Lord bless you in Jesus' name. The week beginning becomes for you a week of miracles, signs and wonders. In the name of Jesus, everything you lay your hands to do will prosper. The Lord will lift you above your enemies. You will see his faithfulness at work in your life. I call your week blessed. In Jesus' name we pray.